Hey guys, this is Simran from ClearTax and in this video, I'll be talking all about the overdraft facility. But before we begin this video, do not forget to press the bell icon and like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates. So let's begin. An overdraft facility provided by the bank allows you to withdraw more money than what is available in your account up to a particular approved limit. It is like a short-term credit agreement between you and your bank. The first one is, an overdraft facility in bank accounts is like a pre-approved loan. The bank ascertains a specific limit up to which you can overdraw on your account balance. You can withdraw that amount as and when you require. The second one is, the approved limit and the overdraft facility interest rate are determined depending on your typical account balance, financial stability, nature of the collateral, etc. Third, the bank charges interest only on the amount used by you and only for the time it is borrowed. It is calculated daily and billed to you every month. The fourth one is, while the overdraft facility interest rate is predetermined, it may increase if you default on paying back the amount due. The fifth one is, you can pay back the amount as and when you have the funds, as a lump sum or in part payment, and there is no prepayment penalty or EMI concept like in loans. The sixth one is, while there is no minimum monthly repayment, you should pay it back when you have the money because it does affect your credit score. Similar to loans, there are secured and unsecured overdraft facilities. It means that if you opt for a secured overdraft account, you will have to provide collateral for the same. There are a few different collaterals you can provide. The first one is overdraft against salary. Overdraft facility for salaried individuals is available against your monthly income. Depending on the bank, you may be approved for a limit of about 2 times your salary. However, to avail of this facility, you need to have a salary account with the same bank. The second one is overdraft against house or property. You can pledge your property to start an overdraft account with your bank. Even if you currently have a home loan that you are paying back, you'd still be eligible after a thorough check by the bank. Typically, banks allow for the overdraft limit to be around 50% of the property's value. The third one is overdraft against fixed deposits. Fixed deposits work as a better collateral alternative than housing property if you don't need a high limit. The process is quicker and the documentation is minimal. Another plus to this option is that if you have a fixed deposit with the same bank you are applying for an overdraft account to, the process will be further expedited. The interest rate is also lower and the limit sanction can be as high as 75% of your fixed deposit. The fourth one is overdraft against insurance policies. Another great collateral option for an overdraft facility is any insurance policy that you hold. The important factor here is that the surrender value of your policy, it is the amount the insurance company will pay you if you decide to terminate the policy before maturity. And the fifth one is overdraft against equity investments. It should be a last resort as equity investments are the least preferred collateral for an overdraft account. Since equities are subject to market fluctuations, the limit sanction for the overdraft facility will be on the lower end. Well, this was it for today's video. Let us know what you think about the video and comment below if you have any doubts. We will try to reply to it as soon as we can. Stay tuned to our channel for more informative videos like these. Till then, goodbye and take care.